Whenever you use DataLink, you always want to get into one habit, and that is clicking on the output cell before you invoke a dialog box from the menu. The reason for that is that all the DataLink dialog boxes, regardless of whichever one you select, will all have in common an output cell and a PI server. The PI server is going to be filled in from your connections dialog box from your default server setting. And the output cell is always going to be filled in from the last cell you clicked on before you invoke the dialog box. So if I want all of my results to appear in the area that I'm highlighting, and I just haphazardly click over here before I invoke my dialog box, then what's going to happen is I will create a query and the results will be in the wrong place, and I will have to cut them and paste them into the correct place. If I would have just select the link formula, if I would have just clicked here where I wanted the results to appear to begin with before I invoked the dialog box, then my spreadsheet would have been filled in as I wanted to with the formatting with the results in the correct cells. So you always want to get in the habit of clicking on the output cell or the desired output cell starting point before you invoke the dialog box. One of the most useful features in DataLink is the modification that our developers have made to the what Microsoft calls the context menu. That's the menu that appears when you right-click on something in Windows. When you right-click on a DataLink function in Windows, what you see is the context menu that appears, and what we've done is we've added elements to the top of that list. And the first three elements will always be these. The first one, select DataLink formula. If you ever want to select an entire array that's returned to you, you would use that option. If you ever wanted to recalculate or resize the formula, remember that the spreadsheet does not automatically recalculate. And also, you may run into the situation where you have a series of values that will return to you, and you change some parameter of the query. Here I will double my query time to 4 hours. And you'll notice that even though there are more values, I went from 23 to 41 values, the array was not lengthened. And to lengthen the array to the proper length, I need to recalculate or resize it. So that's another common use for that. And perhaps the most common feature, the most helpful feature, is the right click and the third item down. The third selection in the context menu will always bring up the original dialog box used for the calculation. So if you do a calculation and for some reason you have the wrong data in it, you don't need to highlight the whole calculation, press delete, and start all over again. You simply right click on the array, select the third item down, and your original dialog box will appear as you originally populated it. When you're building your PI DataLink reports, it's usually helpful to do it as efficiently as possible, especially if you're spending a lot of time building or tweaking reports. I've got a simple spreadsheet here with tag name, start time, and end time, and the appropriate values in column B. And I want to show you how you can gain efficiencies by using cell references. Now, if I were going to build a report like this, and on somewhere in this report I was going to do a compressed values query for this period of time between my start and my end time, what I would do is go into the compressed data start time end time query, and in many cases people would just type the names of the tags into these fields, and you would type in the dates and whatnot, and mainly type in everything into the dialog box. However, that's not the most efficient way to do these operations. What you really want to do is make references to cells, and to do that you simply click in the cell where the value that you want to appear will be, and then you click on its cell on the spreadsheet where the value resides. So you can see that there is no tag name in this cell. It's actually sheet 1, column B, row 4. And I'll do the same thing with start time and the same thing with my end time. Now, by doing this and generating my function that way, what I've done is I've automated the spreadsheet so that the next time I open it up, if it's a different date and time, I don't have to automatically open up my dialog box and go in and tweak it. Or let's say I've got a report that I've generated and I want to find out the results for this report for a different tag. What I can do is simply type in the new tag name, and because I've used a cell reference for that tag name, the entire spreadsheet gets updated. So you always want to try to use cell references in the dialog boxes wherever possible. And you'll notice in the dialog boxes, wherever you see this little underscore, that is the indication that you can use a cell reference in that field. And if you click the underscore, it'll actually minimize the dialog box in order for you to see more of the spreadsheet. You don't have to minimize it. Some people find it is helpful, though.